My name is Guillermo Resil. I'm coming from Basque Country, Spain, in Irún. It's really a specific topic. The first time I am talking about to this is extremely modern, what I am talking. Extremely technique, but I will try to do as calm as possible. But is, I think what I am talking about is the future. This is the future, not also the tachograph, the future of the technology in the world. I think so. Okay, let's see that we are working together with Transport in Knot since last 8 years. We have a lot of experience together. Let's say that we started in transport finds in 1996. After we became, let's say, tachograph technology expert in 2007 with the digital technology. I mean, as expert in laws in Europe, we cannot do an let's say tachograph analysis buying the software or someone else. No. We are expert to do our own interpretation of the software. And we are using our own software to do any kind of interpretation. And this is what I want to talk to today. We are came in expert in formal verification of software since 2014, more or less. And today I want to talk about this. The formal verification of software in tachograph. Let's say that the idea of the speech of today is to take about another point of view about French interpretation of continuous driving time in TIN status. Okay, let's say 1 month ago we have a big problem in France when France changed all the interpretation of the continuous driving time in TIN. And I want to talk about this, but linking to the formal verification of the software. In the beginning of the 20th century, it was a law in Kansas about trains. And it was an article, really well, a good article, just you can read. The article said, when 2 trains approach each other at a crossing, both shall come to full stop. I mean, I think it's really good. Security. I mean, think about you are doing a law that 2 trains are coming. You cannot say, like in traffic, no. Who is coming from the left have preference to, I'm sorry, we are talking about security. Don't give any chance to think to the driver, stop. If someone is coming, stop. Then they put, I think, good, that both shall come to a full stop. Perfect, security, stop. But the next sentence is criminal. And neither shall start up again until the other has gone. Perpetuum, stop. They are stopping forever. Stopping forever. This is a law in Kansas. Okay, this is a law in Kansas. Think about that the policy makers, they contract me as a software expert to do a program to control this with a computer. Think about. I need to do a program to do this. Then, as me, as programmer, I have 2 options. First of all, the lawmakers are doing a law. Perfect. But policies, let's say policies, I am using the word police, not people in the train station. Policies in the train station are telling me, hey, giving me solutions. I cannot have the both train stopped, giving me solution. This is what is happening in the road every day in Europe. I need solutions. Then I can have 1 solution. I am giving preference in my software to 1 of the trains. For example, in the right. I am giving preference. But if I am giving preference to 1 of the trains, there are 2 options that I, as programmer, I know I am violating the law and I am doing. Or 2 options, I don't know. I mean, let's say I am informatic, I am not expert in mathematics, I don't know. I am doing an interpretation and I am giving the preference to the left, but I'm not sure what I am doing. And the other point of view is, no, no, I know that I am programming against the law, but the policies on the road want a solution. Okay. And there are another point of view. They hire me to do a program, I'm going to the policy, I say, it's impossible to do that. It's impossible, there's no solution. You need to change the law. Do you know something about mathematics? Change the law, please. Okay. Do you understand more or less? This is a real situation. It was a real situation in Kansas. Okay, do you understand? It's easy to understand. Okay. This is, I think, good explanation to understand what is happening every day in transport. Let's link this with the last month, what is happening in France. Okay, do know that in 2 of March 2016, the new regulation 165 came fully in force in EU, fully in force. Okay, then France launched a new version of the program Octet, they're using to control in France and also in Belgium, where in team status, when you are in team status, the availability is not considered pause in continuous driving time. They changed this in the program. What friends said about that? Okay, they were using something like this article, this article, these two articles of the 561, the directive this, but especially they were using the article 30, the new article 34 of 165, who was changing the old article 15.3. Antonio will explain later, but all exploded because we had one case of a client of Antonio that it was, for me, an absolutely scandal case. And we exploded. Let's say that we talk with France, Spain, Netherlands, Belgium, also Italy, authorities, and only France was supporting this new interpretation. No one else, only France. And even before of this, the Spanish authorities went to France to talk about this interpretation. And the Spanish authorities said to France, in their face, 2 months before, we are not agree with your interpretation. Okay. Nothing happened. For this case, it was absolutely a scandal, and Antonio will explain really well this case. We move everything. Everything can be moved. In Europe, we move everything. With Paris, with everything. And we contacted with the highest person responsible about 561 in Europe. She's a Polish, Eva Patinska, and she answered us that she thought that France, it was not doing correctly one strange note called Guidance Note 7, and she wasn't supporting the French interpretation. Also, we talked with the prosecutor of that area, and in France, the country was fully supporting, fully, I mean, all the people knows that, and they was supporting fully, also the prosecutor, I supporting my gendarme. Call to Paris, I know this guidance note, but we are not using this. I mean, country decide to put a new version, okay. But European Union wasn't supporting this version. Normally, what something is happened, there are many factors. But I would say proudly that 50% of what I am explaining that is because transport in not in Guretruck push, moved Europe because of one scandal case of Dutch client. There will be a meeting on 26 April, when all the enforcement agencies of Euros, they will have a meeting in Europe, in Brussels, to talk about this French interpretation. this will be analysis of Europe to put in common this French interpretation. Okay, and Guretruck has been formally invited to the meeting as observer.
Hi, my name is René. I'm doing the contact for Guretruck and also for Transport and Node to the European Commission and to some politicians too. As you can see, on 26th of April, we have this meeting, especially regarding France. We put a lot of pressure to the Commission. We directly, or 2 days after we had this case, I contacted them. They were curious about it. They told us, okay, we will check this, and they now also started a formal process against France. But what is more important, actually, in my opinion, we're talking now about France. France is doing something wrong, and it's interesting for nearly everybody in the branch, everybody who's doing team sets. But we have other problems in Europe, like the ferry rule. What we're trying to do is also that we bring a lot of people together and to put pressure on the Commission. And why are we doing this? Or what I'm curious about is that Germany, for example, I wrote to German newspapers and I was trying to tell them, okay, publish this, talk about the French, or about the new French interpretation. And I was wondering, no newspaper in Germany was interested. The biggest branches or the biggest newspapers of the branch, they said, no, it's not interesting because our companies, our readers, the people who buy our newspaper, they don't go to France in team, with team meant vehicles. Okay, I said, we are talking about software verification. We have software which is not correct working in general. We can solve this, probably not in the easiest way, but we can solve it. And this is what we are trying to do, but we have to work together. Not just Holland has to work together, also Germany, Spain. All the people from all countries have to work together to achieve a solution for everybody, because next year it will probably be Germany doing something different than France or than the rest of the European Union. And this is why we are especially, and Antonio is going to explain it later, trying to bring together the force.
I think the French interpretation of the continuous driving time in team will go down. I think so, my opinion. But probably, in one driver situation, probably the standby will be not accepted as a break, as a one driver. As a two driver, maybe yes. This is the moment I will link Kansas, French interpretation, and the formal verification of the software. This is the point. Europe is land of right. We are in a line with right. I mean, when someone is accused, they have right. Okay. As a citizen of EU, we have rights when enforcement agency accuses us. Okay, we have rights. Very clear. Okay, good. Let's follow. Then, do you think it's something extraordinary to ask to European Union, to Dutch authorities, that, hey, when you are buying a program, a software, to put me a fine, in Netherlands, I think they are using the ANTA program. I know perfectly how it's working, the ANTA program. Can someone in Europe, the Transport Administration, the European Union, verify that this program used to put me a fine? In France, you can go to the jail. In Denmark, you can lose many years, the driver license for driving too much. Years. Can someone guarantee that the software is running according to the law? The software is running according to the law. Can I have the guarantee of that? Someone make this homologation? Is something extraordinary I'm asking? I don't think this is something extraordinary. Okay, you can say homologation. Okay, let's do homologation. And this is the trick question. When we are talking about hardware, homologation is easy. I mean, I have a new model of the radar. To do homologation is quite easy. They are using dynamic testing. What is dynamic testing? Dynamic testing is I'm going to a car, I know I am 100 kilometers per hour, they are taking a picture, they must put 100 euro, 100 kilometers per hour, or 99. This is dynamic testing. I am testing result, testing result, testing result. But for software, dynamic testing is a really extremely bad solution. I mean, if you have a, let's say, easy software to do dynamic testing, you can. But when you have a little bit complex system, it's, for me, it's ridiculous to do dynamic testing. It's ridiculous, and I am telling you more. After Volkswagen scandals, for me, forget the dynamic testing. What was happening with Volkswagen scandal? They was doing always dynamic testing. Result, 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 but they had a software cheating the result. Then dynamic testing is, I mean, and in software, dynamic testing is, for me, ridiculous. Then, if we cannot do homologation by dynamic testing, what we can do? And this is the trick. This is the trick concept for the future. This is the concept future. It is formal verification of software as a only guarantee that the any software is working according to a specification. I will tell you one thing. Formal verification of software is the highest level in mathematics you can use. It's huge complexity in mathematics. In this moment, the only branches of the business are using formal verification of the software is banking and aeronautic. I know, let's say, I know someone who Deutsche Bank bought the company, he English, he put it in the city of London, in the highest tower, flat for them, and he's doing formal verification for Deutsche Bank. And when he's writing articles about banking as software verification, stock exchange, these kind of things, believe me, what he's writing is the same experience that we are having in tachograph. The same experience. We have the same experience. Then we are coming expert in formal verification in 5.6.1. And it's complex, extremely complex. But I want to link two results we already have in the formal verification to the topic of today, French case. I will link two points. The first point, okay, someone here can understand me, no. Someone here can understand how a driver can drive in continuous driving time to follow the law? Someone here understand how to drive in continuous driving time? I don't understand one word, how to do continuous driving time. And I am doing programs to read the tachograph in continuous driving time, but I don't understand one word. I don't understand, believe me. Then, let's say, I am not doing any mathematical proof. It is. But if there is a program making finds of continuous driving time, if it is, I did one, policies have many of them, I can prove it is not running according to Article 7 of the 5.6.1. It's not running. Impossible. Even more, it is impossible to do a software of continuous driving time according to Article 7. It is not possible. It's complex, but okay. Then, the thing is, when some driver is fined with continuous driving time, What is the base of the file? What is the base of the file? And I don't know what is the base, but ask the software maker of the program. Ask them. Let's go this with the Kansas. In Kansas, we did two solutions. When I am doing the software to read tachograph, I know the point I am violating. I know perfectly. I am in the first point. I know the point I am violating, and I am informing to authorities, if you want me to do a program of continuous driving time, I need to violate the law. I am telling you directly. This is my point of view. For the most of the program maker, I think everyone, because they are informatic guys, they are not mathematicians, they don't know really what they are doing. I'm sure that the programmer of Dianta, who are finding you in the transport inspection, they don't know what they are doing. We are at a higher level. But believe me, it is not possible to do a fine of continuous driving time according to Article 7. It is not possible. And this is continuous driving time. And believe me, in the tachograph, as also announcing you, you cannot drive more continuous driving time. Let's go to the second point. And here I will do some more complex the thing. The multi-manning situation. I mean, in France, they are talking about continuous driving time, and they are talking about multi-manning. I said, believe me or not, it is not possible to do any software formally verified according to the 561. It's impossible. But the train, I mean, when you are going to talk to the policies, they said, hey, but move the train, please, move the train. And we are moving the train. But move the train means violate the law. Then, if you are, what is the multi-manning? Multi-manning is the Article 4 in the 561. If you are reading the multi-manning, this is extremely, this is the only part I will use mathematics. This is, here what I am using, to prove this is ridiculous. This is extremely ridiculous in mathematics. In mathematics, there is something that you cannot define something with itself. It's impossible. I mean, first of all, informatics is only mathematics. Anything you are doing in a computer behind is mathematics. That's the reason I am talking about formal verification mathematics. All about informatics is only mathematics. The 0101 is only mathematics. All is made about computers is only mathematics. You are looking something screen, beautiful screen, behind is only mathematical rules. Okay. Then, multi-manning. In mathematics, we have one rule. This is something like, you cannot define something with itself. In multi-manning, you are defining multi-manning, you see multi-manning. It's impossible to do that. It's impossible. It's not possible to do define multi-manning. Then, when your computer is telling you the program of the tachograph, he's in multi-manning, what he's doing? I don't know, but he's not feeling the law. Okay. Then, I think the situation for me is quite catastrophic. Quite catastrophic. I mean, the software are not according to the law, and the law cannot be developed by any program. This is catastrophic. And this is what we are trying to convince Europe, that there are rights. There are rights. There are people can go to the jail. There are people can lose years the driver license in Denmark, for example, for a software that is not made by any police. A strange informatic in a strange place in Europe, but he's the god. And that cannot be like that. But be homologated, formally verified by someone. What on the meeting on 26, they are people about interpretation. But we are going to the same point. They are talking about words, words and words. But we are talking, this is the reign of the mathematics. Then people talking about interpretation, believe me, but okay. I think Europe is moving, but also I think the whole technology of the world will change to the hardware homologation, to the software homologation. And finally, to finish in, I will just tell you that the situation of the 3821 and 561 is much worse, much worse than Kansas. Let's talk about tachograph, not 561, tachograph. Okay. We can do the question, we can ask, we are free to ask. I will be extremely polite in this moment, extremely polite. Can we say the tachographs are working according to the Annex 1B? I mean, one symbol, when the tachograph is counting the sensor, click, 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 the sensor impulse, are becoming, driving, rest, is doing according to the appendix 1B, for one example, is doing? You can say, the tachograph is homologated. Did you read what is the homologation of the tachograph? Only hardware. It's only hardware. It's not homologated, the software of the tachograph. Only the hardware is homologated, not the software. Then, is this any proof that the tachograph is marking the driving times according to the appendix 1B? I never find any proof of that. There is no proof. I don't see any work, I don't think. And we did our own investigation. Yes, we did. We have huge software developed about that, huge software. And you can say, how can you check the software of the tachograph if you cannot allow to go inside? Because when you are opening the software, it is blocking. How can you check? We are using a trick using in cosmology. I mean, when the light is coming from the stars, only with the light, I can know everything about the stars. The creation, the atoms, the speed, everything, only with the light. We develop a software analyzing the vehicle files to make the opposite way and to, let's say, create how the software internal of the tachograph is made to create this. We did it. We did it. And we have huge software about that. Eh? And I don't want to say more. I need to be very polite in this moment. But you can say, I don't believe you one word. I don't believe you one word. You are lying. The tachograph is homologated and is working according to the law. Appendix one. You are lying. I will tell you a little trick. You are saying me that the tachograph is running according to the appendix 1B. What appendix 1B? What? What of them? What of them? Look at this. This is the appendix 1B, the rule of the minute, the rule of the minute in different languages. In German, in English, in Polish, and in French, they define for the rule of the minute, very important, remember, the rule of the minute, if you are driving, okay, it's complex, 25 seconds in a minute, you are resting. If you are driving 35 seconds in a minute, you are driving. Rule of the minute. What is a minute? In German, English, Polish, and French, the minute is calendar minute. What is calendar minute? I don't know. What is calendar minute? They are both agree. They four languages are agree. It is calendar minute. I don't know what it is, but it is calendar minute. In Italian, an interval of 1 minute. What is an interval of 1 minute? Anything of 60 seconds. The tachograph in Italian is different to another languages. For what language is homologated tachograph? I don't know, but any language. And in Spanish is something intermediate. In Spanish it is minuto cualquiera, any minute. any minute, I mean, any interval of 60 seconds. Then, depending on the language you are creating a tachograph, you have different tachographs. And we did it. We did simulators of tachographs for all the languages. We have it. Result totally different. Then, if someone is telling me, you are lying, the tachograph software is homologated, I said, okay, which one of the languages? Which one of the languages? It's complex, okay? That's all. Thank you very much.